Hey, Fontana. Happy Halloween. I'm Mayor Acquanetta Warren, and it's time for Mayor Monday. I want to start off by saying thank you to everyone who came out to participate in the Mayor's Education Coalition kickoff. It was a lot of fun, and I can't wait for all the fun activities planned in November. If you have any questions on how to be a part of this amazing program, please email mcarter@fontanaca.gov. Here's an exciting opportunity for our Fontana artists. Omnitrans is seeking artists to paint unique designs on concrete bus benches in Fontana and throughout the county. Submissions close on November 27, 2023, and selected artists will be notified in January 2024. I can't think of a better way to celebrate our artists than to have their passion displayed for everyone to enjoy. You can find more information about the initiative and its submission process by visiting the link shown on the screen. As you see this link, please sign up. Beautiful benches. Next, attend the Day of the Dead celebration on Wednesday, November 1st. Visit the Jack Bullock Center from 3 to 5 p.m. or the Don Day Center from 4 to 7 p.m. to enjoy face painting, activities, games, and more. If you have any questions about this event, please call 909-349-6975. Did you know that you can now buy tickets for the Community Youth Theater performance of Annie Jr.? We have an amazing group of talented youth who will blow you away with this production. So make sure you get your tickets now. Tickets are on sale now and can be purchased online by visiting arts.fontanaca.gov. Performances will take place at the Steelworkers Auditorium on November 3rd at 5:30 p.m. and 8 p.m., November 4th at 2 p.m. and 6 p.m., and November 5th at 2 p.m. I will see you there. Next, Fontana Unlocked is live and available whenever you get your podcasts from. Hosted by Communications and Marketing Manager Monique Carter and Deputy City Manager Ray Ebert. Tune in as they talk about all things Fontana. Have a question for Fontana Unlocked? You can email it at pio@fontanaca.gov. Next, I want to take a moment to acknowledge our great residents. I've received questions and comments regarding their desire to keep our city clean and beautiful. I believe that we are in this together. We all have a responsibility in beautifying our city. One thing you can do to help us keep this city clean and safe is to utilize Fontana 311. Have you noticed an abandoned vehicle on public streets? Overgrown grass and weeds, graffiti, submit a service request with as much information as can be provided, and staff will respond. When you pass by graffiti or potholes, let us know on Fontana 311, and our amazing public works crew will fix it. Fontana is a big city, and we can't do it alone. Let's all work together to improve this great community. Speaking of community, for those with general safety concerns, I highly recommend you attending our Area Commander Community Meetings. These community meetings are an opportunity to meet with members of the Fontana Police Department to address safety concerns and come up with solutions. To find your designated area and upcoming dates, please visit fontanaca.gov. Lastly, I want to take a moment to address the outburst at our last council meeting. I want to make it clear that this council and this city is in support of business. I believe that commerce makes this run, but make no mistake, commerce must comply with the regulations set forth. Whether you operate a grocery store or a nail salon, businesses must adhere to the rules and policy of business. As the city, we have a responsibility to ensure the safety and well-being of our city. This council is committed to that goal. Well, that's all for Mayor Mundy. Thank you for tuning in. Until next time, Fontana Together moves Fontana forward.